Welcome to part 3 of my lecture series on adjusting entries. In this episode, I have decided to discuss only deferred expense or prepaid expense. Deferred revenue or unearned revenue will be tackled in part 4. From the word prepaid, prepaid expense represents advance payment for service to be received or expense to be incurred in the future. The word deferral actually means postponement. Therefore, deferred expense means postponed or delayed recording of expense. From these words, expense to be incurred in the future, postponed or delayed recording of expense. It should be clear that the account title, prepaid expense or deferred expense, is not expense. Rather, prepaid expense or deferred expense is an asset. It is an asset because payment has already been made, but the service is yet to be received. The service will still be received in the future. That means the company paying in advance has the right to receive service in the future. Otherwise, it has the right to get its money back. That's why prepaid expense or deferred expense is an asset. Of course, being an asset, prepaid expense has a normal balance of debit. And being an asset, advance payment for future expense should be recorded by a debit to an asset account. This way of recording is known as the asset method. However, surprising as it may to you, advance payment may be recorded by debiting an expense account instead of an asset account. Since the debit is to an expense account, this recording came to be known as expense method. Nonetheless, the asset method is obviously the preferred method because advance payment for future expense is really an asset. That is why the account title prepaid expense or deferred expense is classified as asset. Now, maybe you would like to ask me, why in spite of the fact that prepayment or advance payment is clearly an asset, some would choose to record it as an expense? Well, maybe their reason is that the prepayment would eventually become expense when the time comes for the company to receive the service for which it paid in advance. Personally though, I don't think that is a good reason. Because come to think of it, isn't it a fact that eventually all of us are going to die someday? Yes, it is. But is it proper to say then that since we are eventually going to die someday, it is better for us to just die now instead of later? Of course not. Not everything that would eventually happen should happen immediately. As the scripture says, there is a time for everything, a time for every purpose under heaven. But anyway, to be able to prepare the correct adjusting entry regarding prepaid expense or deferred expense, you must be able to determine the method used to record the advance payment. You must ask yourself, did the accountant of the company debit an asset account or an expense account? From the answer to your question, you would be on your way to properly making the adjusting entry. Let's have this problem. On September 1, 2019, Almario Law Office issued a check amounting to 250,000 pesos as advance payment for 10 months. The requirement for this problem is obviously to prepare the necessary adjusting entry concerning the prepayment, assuming the company uses the calendar year. But again, before we can do that, it is a must for us to be able to recall the journal entry made by the company to record the advance payment. Let us first assume that Almario Law Office used the preferred method, the asset method, in recording the prepayment. In that case, on September 1, 2019, the company's accountant would have debited the asset account, prepaid rent expense, or simply prepaid rent for 250,000 pesos, and credited cash in bank because the company paid in the form of a check. Hence, the credit is not just to cash, but to cash in bank for the same amount of 250 pesos. Now, from this entry, we have a guide to be able to do the requirement of the problem, which is to prepare the adjusting entry on December 31. Since the company debited prepaid rent here, in our adjusting entry, we have to credit that account. And then, debit its opposite account title. Since in deferral of expense, there are two methods, asset method and expense method, it should be clear that the opposite of asset is expense. Therefore, since we credited the asset prepaid rent here, we must debit its opposite expense account, rent expense. Now, the question is, how much must be the debit and credit? What amount must we compute here? The prepaid rent or the rent expense? The rent expense. Why? Because we debited prepaid rent here and credited the same account here. So, in effect, that canceled out the account title prepaid rent. So that what remains here in our adjustment is the rent expense, which means that we must compute the amount of the expense portion of the rent payment, not the asset portion. To be able to compute that amount of the expense, we must determine the number of months applicable to the expense portion. Recall the difference between an asset and an expense. An asset has future benefit, while an expense has past benefit or no future benefit. From that, we know that the asset, prepaid expense, or deferred expense pertains to future months, while expense pertains to past months. And because here in our adjusting entry, we should be computing for the expense portion of the advance payment for rent, we must know how many months have passed from September 1, 2019 to our adjustment date of December 31, 2019. September 1 to December 31, 2019 is a period of 4 months. We include the month of September, the whole month of September in the accounting because payment was made on the first day of that month. Then, October, November, and the whole month of December because we are making the adjustment on the last day of December. So, September, October, November, December. 4 months have passed. Now, if you have difficulty counting the months mentally or with your fingers, you may do a computation like this. Write December 31, 2019 in numbers. That would be 2019, 12, 31. 12 here represents December because January is 1, February is 2, March is 3, and so on and so forth. Okay, so 2019, 12, 31, representing December 31, 2019. Then, subtract the September 1, 2019 in terms of numbers. That will be 2019, 9, 1. 9 is the numerical equivalent of September because September is the ninth month. 2019 minus 2019 is 0 year. 12 minus 9 is 3 months. 31 minus 1 is 30 days. 30 days is equivalent to 1 month. So, add 1 month to the 3 months and we get 4 months. The number of months from September 1 up to December 31, 2019. Going back here, since we are trying to compute for the amount of the rent expense and knowing that expense pertains to past months and that 4 months have already passed, our computation must be 250,000 rental for 10 months divided by 10 months to get the rental per month. Then, we multiply the per month by 4 months in order to get 100,000. Okay, again, 250,000 is the rental for 10 months. So, if we divide 250,000 by 10 months, we would get the monthly rental of 25,000. Then, we multiply that 25,000 by 4 months, the number of months already passed. That would give us the amount of 100,000 pesos, our adjustment amount. Got that? Now, considering the entries here, how much must appear in the adjusted trial balance and eventually in the notes to the statement of financial position as the amount of the prepaid rent account? 250,000 debit here and 100,000 credit here for a balance of 150,000. How about the balance of the rent expense? We only have rent expense here. Nothing else. A debit to rent expense for 100,000. So, 100,000 is the adjusted balance of the rent expense. We can show computations for those balances by posting these entries to the T account of prepaid rent and rent expense. So, 150,000 pesos adjusted balance of the prepaid rent and 100,000 pesos adjusted balance of the rent expense. But how about if instead of the asset method, the company used the expense method in recording the advance rental payment? Again, although not a requirement in the problem, for us to have a guide for our adjusting entry, let's prepare the journal entry made by the company's accountant to record the advance payment of the rent on September 1, 2019. Because the transaction states that the company issued a check, so the accountant must have credited cash in bank for 250,000. And since we assume he used the expense method, he must have debited the expense account rent expense for the same amount of 250,000 pesos. Now, for our adjusting entry, because the accountant debited rent expense here, we have to credit this account on December 31, 2019. Okay, so the accountant, again, debited rent expense here. So, for our adjustment, we have to credit that. And then, we debit the opposite account title of rent expense, which is the asset prepaid rent. Next, we have to ask ourselves, what amount of adjustment must we compute? The prepaid rent or the rent expense? Because the accountant had debited rent expense here and we credited rent expense here, that we can say canceled out the rent expense account. So that we must compute for the remaining account prepaid rent. Now, remember, prepaid rent is an asset. An asset pertains to benefits to be gotten in the future. Therefore, our next step is to compute for the number of months still in the future. The problem says, the advance rental payment was for 10 months. Therefore, 10 months minus the 4 months already passed, which we have computed a while ago, remember? Will give us 6 months still in the future. Now, let's use the 6 months in our computation. If 250,000 pesos is for 10 months, then 250,000 divided by 10 months will give us the rent per month. If we multiply that monthly rental by 6, then we get the amount of the prepaid rent is still to be consumed in the next 6 months after December 31, 2019. And that amount is 150,000, our adjustment amount on December 31, 2019. I hope you have realized by now that preparing the correct adjusting entry for prepaid expense is not that difficult, as long as you can follow the specific steps needed to be done. Now, based on these two entries, how much is the adjusted balance of rent expense? 100,000. That is 250,000 here minus 150,000 here. How about the prepaid rent? Here, 150,000. This is our only debit to prepaid rent. We did not credit prepaid rent anywhere else, right? So, 150,000 is the amount of the prepaid rent. Notice, these adjusted balances are the same as in the asset method we have computed a few minutes ago. What does that mean then? That means whatever method is used, whether asset method or expense method, after the adjusting entry, the balance of the asset prepaid rent must be the same. And likewise, the adjusted balance of the expense rent expense must also be the same. Because that is really the purpose of adjusting entries. Whatever method had been used, in the end, you must arrive at the correct updated balance of an account. Now here, I will give you a recap of my suggested steps for you to be able to prepare the correct adjusting entry regarding advance payment. You may want to read and understand it on your own. By now, you already know that the first step to successfully prepare the adjusting entry for prepayment is to determine the method used, whether asset method or expense method, in recording the advance payment. But the question is, how will you be able to determine the method used? First, by looking at the unadjusted trial balance for the account title used. Or by the account title mentioned in the adjustment data, in case the unadjusted trial balance is not given. In case the account title is not mentioned in the adjustment data and no trial balance is given, or when the trial balance shows both the appropriate asset account and expense account, assume the asset method was used. Why? Because the asset method is really the preferred method. Now, apply what you learned here in this problem. Determine whether asset method or expense method was used. The prepaid advertising account of 80,000 pesos represents an 8-month advertising contract entered into by the company on October 1, 2019. What method was used? Asset method. Because it says here, the prepaid advertising account. Prepaid advertising is an asset. Therefore, the asset method was used in recording the advance payment. Let's recall then the journal entry made on October 1, 2019. Debit, prepaid advertising, and credit, cash in bank. Although it is not specifically stated in this problem that the company issued a check in payment for the advertising contract, let us use the account title cash in bank. Because most companies follow what is known as the IMPRES system, which requires that all cash payments or disbursements be made by means of checks, except for small amounts, which must be paid out of the petty cash fund. So, since in this problem, the amount involved is quite big, we assume the company issued a check that we credit not just cash, but cash in bank. Now, for our adjustment on December 31. Because the accountant of the company debited prepaid advertising here, we credit that same account, prepaid advertising. And then, we debit its opposite account title. What's the opposite account title of the asset, prepaid advertising? Of course, the expense, advertising expense. Now, since we debited advertising expense, we need to know the number of months already passed or the number of months is still in the future. The number of months already passed. Because again, expense pertains to the past, having already received the benefit in the past. So, how many months have gone by? From October 1, 2019 to December 31, 2019. That's 3 months. October, November, and December. 3 months. Therefore, our computation for the adjustment amount must be 80,000 divided by 8 months multiplied by 3 months already passed. That gives us the adjustment amount of 30,000 pesos. Another problem. Some of the accounts in the unadjusted trial balance of Rosales Hair Cutters as of December 31, 2019 are shown below. A count of the office supplies showed 2,300 pesos remaining on hand as at December 31. Here, the unadjusted trial balance is given, or at least some of the accounts in the trial balance. So, we will be able to know the method used in recording the purchase of the office supplies by looking at this trial balance. Do you see the asset account office supplies or prepaid office supplies or the expense account office supplies expense? Office supplies expense is what we see here. That means what? The expense method was used. In other words, the accountant of the company debited office supplies expense upon purchase of the office supplies. And therefore, for our adjusting entry, what should we do with this office supplies expense debited by the accountant here? We have to credit this office supplies expense December 31, 2019. And then, we debit what? The opposite of what we have credited here. What's the opposite of office supplies expense? The asset office supplies. Now, what amount do we need to know? The amount of the asset office supplies or of the office supplies expense? The amount of the asset office supplies. Why? Because that's the debit in our adjusting entry. Remember, normal balance of asset and expense is debit. That's why you have to look at what you debited here. Or if you want, look at the entry upon purchase of the supplies. The accountant had debited office supplies expense. And then, in our adjustment, we credited the same account title, office supplies expense. That we can say, canceled out the office supplies expense. One debit, another credit, so canceled out the account title, office supplies expense. So, that leaves the account title, office supplies, in our adjusting entry. Therefore, we have to look at the amount of the asset office supplies for our adjustment amount. So, how much is the remaining asset office supplies? Here, 2,300 pesos remaining on hand. Meaning, the remaining asset office supplies amounts to 2,300 as at December 31. So, 2,300 is our adjustment amount. Up next will be deferred revenue or unearned revenue. Thank you and keep safe.